can't help thinking that somewhere in the universe there has to be something better than man. Has to be.
The words are Charlton Heston's.
Get out a last signal to Earth that we've landed!
The world he finds out in the galaxy will challenge every idea you've ever had of civilization. A planet where man is the lowest order of living things, and the superior beings are apes. They build the cities, make the laws, the gods, and control the guns that hunt a race of lowly terrified humans who run wild in the jungles, are caged in the prisons, and stuffed in the museums. 20th Century Fox transforms the motion picture screen into Planet of the Apes. Pierre Boulle's finest novel since Bridge on the River Kwai.
It was a world gone insane, an upside-down civilization that could not be real. Yes, a world of madness and terror.
Man has no understanding. He can be taught a few simple tricks, nothing more. You did it. You cut up his brain, you bloody baboon! It's a man! It's a man!
But it did not end here. It ended in an episode so unpredictable, so shocking, that it made the horror which preceded it seem calm and gentle as a summer's night. A great many people worked long and hard to answer the question of what a civilization would be like where the evolutionary process had been reversed and apes were the superior species. Hundreds of technicians and the largest number of makeup artists ever assembled assisted the producers, the writers, the director, and the cast. Dr. Cornelius, Roddy McDowell. Dr. Zira, as played by Kim Hunter. Dr. Zayas, as portrayed by Maurice Evans. And Nova, by Linda Harrison.
Now the tribunal has placed you in my custody for final disposition. You realize what that means?
No.
Emasculation to begin with. Then experimental surgery on the speech centers, on the brain. Eventually a kind of living death.
Planet of the Apes, beyond your wildest dreams.